Okay, so let's create some to-do objects. Now, if we come into the to-do rest, the to-do resource, or the create resource in the to-do resource class takes a post, is a post method at the path create. So let's come in here and say body JSON. Let me remove everything here. This is a post. We're making a request to-do /create. And then remember our bearer token has to be here, the header as usual, application JSON. So let's create our JSON object. The first one is the task, like this. The task is master Jakarta EE, and then the second one is the due date, like this. Is 2018 December 31st. Now, if we come into the code, this is the to-do object, and there's two fields that are required, the task and then the due date. Now, the due date, this is the format, year, month, and date. That is what the JSON B date format annotation here is telling the runtime. So this is what we should pass as JSON, and that's exactly what we've done here. So we have our two fields. Let's send. Okay, so we have our to-do object. You can see archive false, completed false, date created, due date. So this is essentially the two things we set, the due date and then the task here. And then you can see the owner, which is this particular field here. This one, the to-do owner, this one is what has been passed back in here as well. Now, there's a small problem. I wouldn't say small, but there's a problem here. You see, anytime we request for a user, we get the hashed password in return. We should be able to tell the JAX-RS runtime that when you are marshalling our Java entities to JSON, the JSON equivalent, we don't want you to marshal the password and then the salt field. We don't want you to marshal that. So we have to keep that at the back of our minds. It's something we need to fix. So let's keep that. Now let's create a little more to do. So master Jakarta EE. Let me create another to do. Say create an enterprise app in Jakarta EE. So the deadline should be 2019 February 20th. This is just a random date. So let's hit send. Okay, so there's another one. Let's create another one. Travel to the Bahamas, let's say 2019 March, the deadline is March 31st. Let's hit send. Okay, so we have three to-do objects in our database. Now let's come back here. Let's come to the to-do rest. So we have created to-dos here. If we want to list the to-dos, we go to the list path. So let's come here. Let's list. Let's say get. It's a get method. Yep, it's a get method. So let's come down here, get. There's no body. But remember, this still has to be there. This has to be passed with every request. Our JWT has to be passed with every subsequent request to the server. So let's hit this. And so we have our list of to-dos here. So this is the first to-do, this is the second to-do, this is the third to-do. Now again, you can see all of them have the to-do owner, which is the same user that we have. So this one, then this one. In fact, we can even tell the JAX-RS runtime to not include all of this field at all in the marshalling from the Java entity to the its JSON equivalent. We can tell it not to do this, but we'll leave it. But we are interested in not showing these two fields, the password and then the salt. We don't want to marshal those to JSON. So keep that at the back of your mind. We'll be coming to fix that. So this is it. This is our to-dos that we've created. Let's come again and see what else we can do. We can find a to-do by ID using a query param. So let's come here. Let's pick the third one. Let's say find. You can pass a query param. We come here, you say ID. And then we pass in the query param ID of, let's say, 4. Let's hit send. So we can use the query param, this one, this resource. So we send a get request to the find method, and then we pass in the query param of ID, which is what has been extracted and done for us. So you can see the Insomnia REST client has actually created a very valid URI for us. So this is the ID, we pass the ID value of 4, and then we have this in return. So let's come again, find, we can mark a to-do. So mark a to-do as completed. Let's come here, mark, and then we pass in the ID. So let's come to mark like this. Hopefully everything works out fine. So let's mark the same to-do as completed. Let's hit send. Let's look at the method. It's a put method. So we need to change. We need to change this to put like this. Then let's hit send. Let's hope everything works. So nothing was returned in the body. So it means everything is working successfully. So we marked that particular to-do as completed. Now let's come and get all completed to-dos here. Let's hope this also works. Get is a get request. So we come here, we say get, and then no query param or anything. So let's come here. Let's just remove this like this, and then let's come here and say completed. Let's hit send. Okay, so you can see that what we marked, the to-do we marked as completed, is exactly what we are getting in return. Let's come again. Uncompleted, let's send. So you can see now we have two uncompleted to-dos in our system. So this and this. Okay, so we can archive, we can search by due date. At least all our resources here are working fine, which means that so far, what we are doing is okay, it's working now. What we have is a perfectly valid system, but there's always room for improvement. So let's see where and where we can make improvements. We will refactor our code, use the Java EE APIs actually, use the Jakarta EE APIs to improve the code we have. What we have is okay, but there's always room for improvement. So let's come again here. And then see header, cookie, blah, blah, blah. Let's come to, there's something I want us to do. Let's come to do. In fact, let's come to user forward slash list. Let's list the users. It's a get method header like this. Let's hit send. So user does that. So first one, this one, we need to tell the JAX-RS runtime to not marshal those to JSON. That's one. Okay, fine. Now, let's go into the code and then make our requisite changes and see how we can improve our code. Now, the other important thing actually, I want us to also have at the back of our mind is that even though HTTP, REST protocol is supposed to be stateless in one way or the other, we are sort of tied to the client because we are using this session scope to track the currently logged in user's email. And that means we send a cookie with every request to the client. Now, we can refactor this to make it better. So overall, at least now we know our system is working. Let's come again to do. Let's list. Let's get everything. So this is our to-do. This is a list of our to-dos. We know everything is working as it should, which is fine. Now let's go into our code and improve things one after the other. We're going to be using the Jakarta EE APIs to refactor our code to improve upon it.